everyone. Welcome back to integralcalc.com. We're going to be doing another trigonometric substitution problem today. In this one, we're given the integral on the range 0 to 10 of dx divided by the quantity x squared plus 25. So first, we're going to talk about how to set up our trigonometric substitution problem. We're going to need a couple formulas, and then we can do the setup. Once we do that, we'll make substitutions, simplify the integral, integrate on the range 0 to 10, and then simplify and solve. So here's the formula we're going to need. For this particular problem, we need to recognize that we have the denominator here in the form u squared plus a squared. U represents our variable, always, x, and a represents a constant. And because we have addition here, we know that we're making the particular substitution of u squared plus a squared. So we grab this as our identity, and two pieces that go along with this here, u squared plus a squared. If we're going to make this substitution, or if our integral is in this form, what goes along with that is this formula u equals a tangent of theta, and this substitution here, which is going to come later in the problem. So first thing that we have to recognize, like I said, is that our denominator, x squared plus 25, is actually in the same form as u squared plus a squared. Remember that u is the variable, so u is going to be equal to x, and a is the constant, so a is going to be equal to 5, right? So can you see that if you plug in x for u here and 5 for a, that you're going to end up with x squared plus 25 instead of u squared plus a squared? That's how we find u and a. So we say that u is equal to x and a equals 5. Once we find those two values, then we can plug them into the second part of our formula here, u equals a tangent of theta. And what we'll get, of course, is x equals 5 tangent of theta. We plugged in x for u and 5 for a. So x equals 5 tangent of theta. Now we need to do several things with this. The first thing is to take the derivative of x, dx. When we take the derivative, the 5 stays there. The derivative, just by the formula, of tangent of theta is secant squared of theta. So that's why we get the secant squared of theta here. And then because we took the derivative, we add on this d theta here. Now, a couple additional things we need to do. We need to solve for tangent of theta. If you have a different kind of trigonometric substitution, you're solving for the trigonometric identity here, whether it's sine of theta or secant of theta, whatever it is. So we need to solve for this trigonometric identity, and all we have to do to accomplish that is divide both sides by 5. So tangent of theta equals x over 5. We're doing all of these pieces because they'll help us out later. If we set everything up at the beginning, then we can just grab these pieces when we need them and plug them in. So so we have tangent of theta equals x over 5. Now we want to go ahead and solve for theta. And the way that we do that is to take tangent to the negative 1 of both sides. When we take tangent to the negative 1 of the right side, tangent to the negative 1 and tangent will cancel each other out, and we're just left with this theta here on the right side. But we'll get tangent to the negative 1 of x over 5 on the left side. So we can use this value for theta to plug back in at the end of our problem. And then the last thing that we need to do, and drawing the this triangle here is not always necessary in a trigonometric substitution problem, but I just like to do it up front because you might need it later, and to go back and draw it after the fact, might as well just get all of the setup steps done up front. So this is the triangle that is specific to this tangent identity here. Like I said, there's different trigonometric substitutions that you can make. This one is matched up with this u equals a tangent of theta identity here. And what it tells us is that because we're making this tangent substitution, that our angle theta is over here. You can always draw your right triangle in this form with this theta angle over here. It tells us that the opposite side, remember opposite, adjacent, and hypotenuse, the opposite side is going to be equal to u, which in our case is x. the adjacent side is going to be equal to 5, or a, and the hypotenuse is going to be equal to the square root of u squared plus a squared. That is the definition of this tangent triangle here. So we just go ahead and draw that in, and if we need it later, we can use it, but there it is. So let's go ahead, and now that we've got everything set up, get to plugging into our integral, making substitutions. Before I go to the next slide, notice here a couple substitutions we're going to make. We have dx here in our original integral. Well, we solved for dx as 5 secant squared of theta d theta. So that's one substitution we're going to make. You're going to see that in the numerator. We also solved for x. So in place of x, we're going to put 5 tangent of theta. So this is going to go in for x. So here's what that's going to look like. We put in, like I said, 5 secant squared of theta d theta for dx, and we put in 5 tangent of theta for x here. So those are the two substitutions that we made. Now we can go ahead and start simplifying. First thing that we're going to do is distribute this squared exponent here. So we have 5 squared, which is equal to 25, and then tangent of theta squared gives us tangent squared of theta. We leave everything else the same. Now we can factor out 25 in the denominator. This is always kind of the general set of steps that you want to follow when you're doing trigonometric substitution. You probably end up with a squared term here, whether it's in the numerator or the denominator. You want to distribute that. You're going to end up with something that you can factor out, hopefully. So you'll want to grab this 25 and factor it out. The reason that you follow that specific set of steps is because notice that when we factor out this 25, we end up with tangent squared of theta plus 1. And you can remember from our formula, the third part of our formula, remember we said we were going to use the substitution later? Look, we have 1 plus tangent squared of theta, which is the same as tangent squared of theta plus 1. So we can now substitute secant squared of theta for tangent squared of theta plus 1, which is going to make our integral a lot easier. So that's what you're driving toward. When you have this trigonometric substitution problem, you want to try to get one of these, either the left side of this equation by itself or the right side by itself, so you can make this substitution right here. So as it turns out, we got the left side, so we're going to plug in secant squared of theta. And two things are going to come out of this. Notice that we have 5 over 25, which reduces to 1/5. And because everything inside this integral is one term, we've got everything kind of multiplied together, this 1/5 is a coefficient on this fraction. So we can pull it out in front of the integral. And then remember, we make the substitution secant squared of theta for tangent squared of theta plus 1. So all that's left inside of our integral is secant squared of theta over secant squared of theta, which of course is going to reduce to just d theta. These will cancel out and you'll just get 1. So we could write 1 d theta, but it's redundant. So we're just going to find the integral of d theta, which, as you probably know, happens to just be theta. If you're taking the integral of dx, it's just x. In this case, we have d theta. So our integral is theta. The 1/5 stays. And now we're going to evaluate on the range 0 to 10. So before we can evaluate, we have to plug back in for theta. Remember that when we were setting up our trigonometric substitution problem, we solved for theta. And we found that theta was equal to tangent to the negative 1 of x over 5, you remember? So now we plug back in for theta, tangent to the negative 1 of x over 5. And now that we have everything set up here, we can evaluate on these limits. So remember, when you're evaluating on limits, you plug in the top number first, which is 10. So you see we plugged in 10 here. And then you always subtract in the center. And then you plug in the bottom number, which is 0. So we plugged that in there. And now it's just a matter of simplification. If you plug in tangent to the negative 1 of 0, because obviously this 0 over 5 will reduce to 0, you're going to get 0 in your calculator. So you know that this whole second term here, it's going to go away. It's equal to 0. So all we have to think about is the first term, and you don't have to, and you shouldn't, compute this to, you know, decimal places unless you're specifically asked to do so. So all we have to do is reduce it, and you see we have 10 over 5, which is going to reduce to 2. So our final answer is actually just going to be 1/5 tangent to the negative 1 of 2 plus c, and we add that plus c, of course, as with any integral to account for the constant of integration. And that's our final answer. So we didn't end up using our triangle from our setup, and we didn't end up using everything that we calculated, but if you go through that same set of steps for the setup, you'll have everything you need, and you'll be good to go for the rest of the problem. It makes things a lot easier. So I hope this example helped you guys, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!